sorry, Mr. Bergeron's on. Don't forget the popcorn, Frank.
Coming, dear.
We also had to tell you to keep fire extinguishers nearby, but keep them hidden so that somebody wouldn't inadvertently set them off. We talk about fires. Where's the number one place to have a fire? Your kitchen. And how do you prevent that? So there's a couple of very neat products out. This one over here is a fire suppression system. And it fits right up under your hood, or even if you have a microwave above your oven, it fits right up underneath there. And what it does is senses heat. So if a fire does start, it'll just automatically suppress it. And it's good for whether you use a gas or an electric stove. The same as this one. This one over here is a sensor.
So that obviously, that's not spraying water. So you don't have to mix it into it.
Just no, like, it has like a pressure. It's a chemical that it right. shoots down. Right. Similar to, I don't know, I was exposed to one at a gas station. Somebody's cell phone set off the fire suppression system, and I happened to be in a convertible at the time. It was quite the event. But yes, the chemical comes out, and you know, it's good to know what happens. This one is a sensor, and what it does is you put it on your stove, and it senses where, how many people are there, or how long you're there. There's a couple of number of different types. One will sense your body heat, one is on a timer. If it says that, okay, I don't sense anybody here for 5 minutes, it shuts down your stove completely. And then there's other ways. You can hook an on-off switch, or you can kill your circuit breaker. There's a number of ways you can deactivate your stove and your cooktops for somebody who's going to be staying at home by themselves and you don't want them cooking. We talked about childproof latches. In that same safety kit, there's childproof latches. Put them on all the cabinets and doors and drawers that you don't want somebody going into. Same as my house is now done for my grandchild. We tell you to install locks on all cabinets with breakables that you don't want broken. Anything that has cleaning products in it, medications, alcohol, matches, knives, sharp utensils, plastic bags, because we don't think about that, but they're not going to remember what a plastic bag is, and it could be something that could injure them. And your family favorite junk drawer, because we all have one. I have more than one. But in that junk drawer are things that not will be remembered as to what their uses are and could very easily hurt somebody. We also tell you to remove from the premises or lock up completely power tools. We had a client, he was a wonderful wood maker. He went out into his shop thinking he was going to create something and got injured. So we recommend very strongly all hand tools, even as simple as a hammer. Power tools, guns, machinery, in a locked garage, basement, shed, or removed from the premises completely. Stairs. Other than putting in a chairlift, which is a wonderful thing to do, we also recommend gates. Because somebody may not be ready for a chairlift yet, but they still think that they want to climb the stairs either up or down, but really need some assistance to do that, or they don't remember how to do that. So if you put a gate, it will stop them from going up or down the stairs. Bathroom. I'm on a one-woman crusade to put a grab bar in every bathroom across America. Because whether you're 3 or 103, you can use it. And it helps when you're falling. But we definitely recommend that you have a professional install it. Because you don't want to be slipping and falling, grabbing that grab bar, thinking it's going to hold you, and it give away from the wall, because you'll get hurt twice as much. We talked about visual perception. What happens when you have a white toilet seat on top of a white toilet? You can't see where to go. So we recommend a different, very easy fix. Just put a different color, a wood color, a brown color, any other color on your toilet seat, and that will give the person a visual, okay? This is what I have to do, this is where I go. In a bathroom, we tell you to also lock up or remove anything, razors, medicines, shaving cream, anything of that nature. Hair dryer, small electrics, electric toothbrushes even. Anything that needs to be plugged in because it could be cause an injury. Tell you to label your hot and cold levers as well as your shampoo and conditioner. And my number one favorite, I have an Elmo one, but they do come in non-caricatures. a foam cover on top of your tub spout. Because if you do slip and fall, if somebody does slip and fall, it will help minimize. Remember we talked about minimizing the danger? Having that foam rubber, if a head gets hit, it's not going to hurt and cause as bad of an injury if it's just that metal piece with the sharp edges. Anti-scald devices, another great product to use, because as we get older, our skin gets much thinner, and so we feel hot water a lot more frequently, and we can get burned more easily, especially if you don't have a limit on your hot water heater, and your water coming out of that temp gets very, very, very hot. So an anti-scald device will prevent that. We talk about lights. I tell you to put night lights in a lot of places. Some people use the night lights that come on and off automatically when you enter a room. Some people might get frightened by that. So you really have to depend upon the person that you love and how they're reacting. But we definitely ask you to light the way. Light the pathway down to the bathroom. Some places we put arrows so people know where to go. Because sometimes there's a long space between where the bedroom is and where the bathroom is. And they'll get out into the hallway and get lost in the middle of the night. So between the night lights and either a contrasting color tape or an arrow, it'll help direct them. Guidance. Step onto an airplane landing. A guidance. A way to go. And also outside. We talk about lighting outside. Because if you're outside taking a walk in the evening with your loved one and you come back, between their visual and their somewhat disorientation, a light outside will help light their way so you can see the front door. And that's another presentation I can talk to you about all the different funky front door things that you can use. They have automatic front door openers now, similar to this. You just press the button and the door opens for you. General, smoking. I'm an advocate of non-smoking, but people do smoke. And I take that into a lot of consideration, and sometimes it's very enjoyable. My father has smoked a pipe for many, many, many years. And as he's aging, I watch him more because he has accidents with that pipe. He's burnt more holes in his shirt than my mother cares to mention. But if somebody that you love has dementia and does enjoy smoking, we invite you to sit with them while they're doing it because they may forget that they've lit that cigarette and it will cause a fire if they leave it unattended. But even better still, if you remove the cigarettes, the ashtrays, the matches from their presence, they may not remember that they smoked and they'll get a little benefit from that. We talk about red tape, red being a stop. We invite you to put it on register that might get hot. So because the person with dementia will not remember and maybe they'll step on it in their feet, and because they have a thinner skin, they could get burnt, get hurt. So we tell you to put red tape around radiators and floor beds, things of that nature. Remove trippable hazards, both in the house, but also outside of your house. How many of you garden? And you leave your gardening tools or your hose, and you know you're going to put it away in a minute, but somebody with dementia may come along and trip on it. So we recommend that you clear your paths both inside and out. And secure gates to your pool, to your shed, to your yard, to your gas grills, because people won't remember what that is and they might play with it. And again, same as inside, it could cause a fire or somebody to get burnt or hurt. And your trash bins. People look at me, really? I have to lock up my trash? Somebody with dementia, and I missed it before, doesn't have the taste of spoiled food. So we tell you to clean out your refrigerator as well, because they will go into a refrigerator and they're not going to know that the milk that you have in there is 2 weeks old, past its due date, and it's coagulated and disgusting, and they'll drink it because they don't have that same sense of taste. They'll open up a garbage can and see last night's dinner there and say, oh, that's still good to eat. I can eat that. So we tell you to lock things up, clear out the refrigerator. Keep small pets out of walking paths as well, because somebody that has a visual isn't going to see the cat lying on the floor, and both the cat and the person may get injured. We talk about personal things that you can do. For your loved one, call your neighbors, call the police department, bring a recent picture of the person with you, give it to people, because if your loved one has wandered, which does happen in this disease because they have a place they have to go to, and they did get out of the house somehow, they may be wandering around. Notify your neighbors if they see, if you see Mary out of the house, and she's really not supposed to be out of the house without one of us, please call the police or please call us, because you'll get her back faster. We also recommend you take an article of your loved one's clothing and put it in a plastic bag by the door, because it will help tracking dogs very quickly locate your loved one.